People Clerk here. Is there any way to separate the decision of what you do with the basin versus us just beating it over? And then you can decide what you want to do with it, and we don't need to be involved with it, really? Do we really care? Maybe you do, you live right there.
A little, yeah.
I mean, there's only so much you can do with the space, so, I mean, if we've talked about maybe children play equipment, I know that's been talked about a lot with the ones who live around the area, or the dog parking lot. But that's just an idea, I thought.
They are related, but two distinct decisions by the council, I believe, you know. It's great to hear some ideas for what can be done, and I'm not trying to prolong the process as much as I'm trying to be sure that committees and boards that the council appoints aren't overlooked for their responsibility for what we've asked them to, you know, do. But I'm not opposed to the city taking it over. But we have to grapple with the maintenance issues and even the use issue. I think Ken Herington brought up the issue of concern about pollutants that could collect there, et cetera. And just, do we have health issues? I mean, there's so many little, you know, things that tie into this. I don't have a problem with the city taking it over. I know one thing I think we asked the staff to do is to check and see if whatever your homeowners' dues are out there, if that could somehow be set up for a district, keep that going. So that would defray a portion of the cost the city would incur to keep the maintenance of it. But it takes the burden off of you as a group of homeowners to have an association on the county related with that. And it puts it more properly, in my opinion, on the city. As far as what the city does with that, I'd be in favor of it being something useful to the city, but I really want to hear planning and zoning weigh in on that specific, what is done with that. There is a park plan for the northern, the next sections of subdivisions that go up north of that area for a nice community park. That's in the comprehensive plan. Mm-hmm. So.
And then also, if the city takes ownership of it, potentially takes ownership of that, detention basin, that does set precedent for other developers. And so that's why it does take some thought into this. And thought does take time. So, are there any other comments? Questions?
When does this P&Z meet for our next meeting?
No, it'll be the Wednesday after our next meeting.
When?
But then, yeah, I mean, no matter what you think, I mean, you want to weigh in on, you think the BNC should weigh in on, or think about the dog parking issue, or what were their thoughts on the city taking possession or taking ownership of that basin?
I guess the general consensus was the city, you know, should assume that responsibility.
Okay.
You know, since it's part of kind of how we're tailoring the revised subdivision and zoning ordinance.
Right. But it's, how about the use of it? I mean, then, do you want to weigh in on the use of it, or is that a P&Z issue?
I don't think that's a P&Z issue. It's probably more part of parks and recreation.
Okay, and that's what the city wants to deal with.
Yeah. Yeah. I think the consensus was that, you know, some viable use that's going to be agreeable to the engineer.
Okay.
Rather than weighing in on something specific.
So really, you know, parks and rec is the biggest portion of this, and I think that if you guys meet before the next meeting, then council should or could make a decision before the meeting in November. How do you feel about that, Steve? I mean, what can you do?
Yeah, I just think they need to weigh in.
Okay, but P&Z, I mean, do you want to wait for P&Z?
If Larry, as the chair, doesn't feel they should weigh in, maybe we could check with some of the others on the committee just to see what their feeling would be, and they're all in agreement, then that's fine with me.
Just to expedite this thing.
And maybe I missed something, but also we do have the issue that the city's engineer has said, no, don't use that for recreational purposes. purposes, and maybe we just need that next communication, if there was one that was modifying that, because I'm concerned if our city engineer says don't do it, why the council would cross that unless the city engineers come back and weigh in on something different.
I think what it's into, if I recall the letter, was that he didn't want us to modify anything. Did I read something like that?
I don't know, but I have it.
The letter here stated, retention base was not designed for auxiliary uses, therefore access to pedestrian and parking for the monitor in public was not anticipated. Maintenance user, along with a request for auxiliary use, is a request that the local government take over maintenance of the detention area. This is usually something the government is not equipped to do, which we spoke today. We're looking at probably 4 hours of mowing for each mowing, and last year I think they mowed it twice. Obviously, if we changed the use and put a dog park in there, our mowing would go up on there, but the mowing acre is typically 1 hour for us. Safety, there will be times the detention basin will be wet, soggy, muddy, and could pose problems if there is standing water, and its use is a park that attracts young children. Functionally, the detention basin was designed for a specific use and with a specific storage capacity. Alteration to the existing feature or the addition of items could compromise how the basin was designed to function. In my conversation with him today, I asked specifically for what use, this use, and how he would deem it. And he said it would be appropriate for there, and it would be something that would not sustain extended damage should the basin be full of water for an extended period of time. It would just be the maintenance of cleaning up around the chain link fence, the debris that would get to it. So he said as long as the city was comfortable with those individuals knowing that dog park was closed, being I'd be under water, then he was comfortable with the usage.
I think he didn't want us to put in groundwater. Is there a good to re-scope of diamond or a ball diamond and stuff like that? What is the green ingredient? I don't think it's an issue. And again, knowing
when it's closed. Well, you can close it by padlock. Put a padlock on the gate, close it due to water. Pretty obvious.
I have to log out to the water, put the riders on, hit the gate, and know it's closed.
Yep.
And yes, there were recent debris, the chain link was fancy catch. That would not be restricted had there not been a fence there. You know, the fence will be, it will not be maintenance free.
But more time to the issue. My major concern is just the liability issues that might come about from a dog park, interaction of dogs. You know, and dog park is all nice and great, and it's in a neighborhood where the one up in Iowa City is sort of out in the middle of no place, so if dogs are barking all the time, you know, there's nobody to complain about that. Is this going to end up being an issue where the homeowners are going to come back and say, oh, these dogs are barking all the time, you can do something about the park after we've made this investment?
I think it's probably time to state that they will never complain.
Can we do that? Can we have that in the rain?
It's actually amazing how much the dogs don't bark when they're in the park.
Yeah.
I mean, it really is, because that's what I thought too, is this is going to be noisy, and it's not. The dogs don't even bark that much.
Well, I'm sure they're not out there that long, right?
Oh, I'm usually there a couple hours.
Really?
Oh yeah, I'm sure you sleep good on it. It's like taking your kid and putting them in a swimming pool, man. They sleep all the
time.
Yeah, we have absolutely love going up to the dog park, but I would just assume pay my fee here and use our dog park and driving an hour's round trip to use Iowa City.
I've never had a dog, so I mean I'm listening to a water stand, and it sounds like it's a market. Is that an issue?
I don't know about up there at Scott Boulevard, but
usually, like you said, they bark less once they're in their visitor off leash and doing whatever they want.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a dog. If they want to bark, they bark.
So different than if you put a park down or the kid all screaming.
I mean, really.
Dogs
make or bark. Yeah, but you put playground equipment, the kids are going to be screaming.
I do agree that usually it seems like they bark less in there, but yeah. Who knows if that's
He barks more going in because he's saying hi to everybody than he does once he gets in, you know?
But I think parks on the park and recreation.
Anything else? And we're put this on the agenda for next meeting again, and we're gonna report from parks and rec, see what they, what input they have.
So what are we gonna do with the issue of taking the retention basin over and all? Because they are two separate.
Correct.
Issues. Is that anything you wanna take action on or talk about further tonight?
Okay, so, like Steve said, there is really two issues. Number one, whether or not the city wants to accept the retention basin, and then what use of it. So if P&amp;Z has no issue with the city taking ownership of it, we can take action on that tonight, which would really please Lori.
I'll still come back next month to hear about the dog park.
Now, when you do take it over, she's not gonna come back and complain, you're not putting the dog.
Ideally, kind of what we talked about is the homeowners association agreeing to, in writing, what we're doing out there, because there is gonna be future growth out there and those individuals that come in there. And more than likely, there may be somebody that disagrees with what they do after they buy a house that's not up right now. So then we can let them know that we did consult the homeowner association with what we were doing out here. And it was a give and take relationship to come to this point. So.
If the city takes ownership, Lori, does the homeowners association have any other purpose? So that would be dissolved.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So do we want to see a statement from all current members of the homeowners association stating that they're okay with our intent?
I would personally, in our talks, we'd look to have one document that would just say homeowners association and its members, and we'd leave that up to their governing body to come up with.
Okay.
At our annual meeting, we did vote, and we had the majority vote that if the city would take it, that we would deed it over. Is that minutes from that meeting good enough?
Or yes.
We can give you that.
And that everybody would be happy?
Yes.
With however we used it?
Yep.
All right.
He says majority vote. That it wasn't 100%.
So
there's gonna be a few people that are happy about it.
Majority.
The ones that voted yes will.
From everybody that was there, not one person voted no, did they? I mean, honestly, I do not remember anybody saying they were opposed.
Did you do a roll call vote or anything?
No.
Okay, just raise a hand.